A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 18th Feb, on the front page you have J&K administration withdraws security to separatist leaders. So after the Pulwama terror attack in which 40 CRPF jawans were killed, Jammu and Kashmir government has decided to withdraw security which is provided to separatist leaders in Jammu and Kashmir. So they say we don't need to waste our police resources. Then the next is central forces to be moved by air for Kashmir deployment. The Ministry of Home Affairs has now approved a plan to charter flights to transport central armed police forces personnel deployed in Kashmir Valley through these commercial flights. So they will be available 6 days a week exclusively for the movement of personnel from Srinagar to Delhi and back to Srinagar, or from Srinagar to Jammu and back to Srinagar. Then next is, on page 2 you have bullock cart racing to make a comeback at Kila Raipur meet. So Punjab government has given its nod to enact a law in present assembly session that will be a law to amend Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act. So you can see Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, Punjab Amendment Bill 2019 has been given a nod by the cabinet. So this will be passed and sent to the central government for approval, so that, because it's a central government enacted act, so that is why it has to be sent to the central government for approval. Once the president approves it, then the act comes into effect, and this will give exemption to bullock cart races and which is held in Punjab at the annual Kila Raipur Rural Sports in Ludhiana. So you should know that Supreme Court has banned such events, such bullock cart races in 2014, but still states have put them into effect through various amendments. So we see in Tamil Nadu it is Jallikattu, which has been allowed through an amendment to Prevention of Cruelty Act, the central legislature in Tamil Nadu. So Tamil Nadu amendment bill has been approved by the government, central government too. Then in Karnataka also we have the example of Kambala, which is a buffalo racing festival. Again, that has been using the same route to get its approval, and now it's Punjab which is getting approval for bullock cart racing. Then on page 4 you have 90,000 farmers counseled in 14 suicide prone districts of Maharashtra. So Maharashtra government has initiated this project called Project Prerna, in which the state is providing counseling to farmers in suicide prone districts, in 14 suicide prone districts of Maharashtra. So 12,700 personnel have been trained to be part of this project, Project Prerna. On page 5 you have doctors, CAs among BPL cardholders. So these are checks which have been conducted which have exposed ineligible beneficiaries. So cross verification of database available with Telangana Agriculture Department to identify beneficiaries of Prime Minister Kisan Samman Nidhi at Gram Sabhas in villages has revealed stunning details about these doctors and CAs being BPL card holders. So there are around 3000 pensioners, doctors, advocates, CAs, ex-MPs, MLAs and ministers who have been found in possession of white ration card, which is issued to BPL families as such. On page 7 you have cut down the wire, Punjab's black buck fight for existence. So stray cattle, dogs and barbed cobra wires, and even the changed land use pattern has been troubling the state animal of Punjab, that is the black buck. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Delhi Dilemma. So this is regarding Supreme Court's split decision on central union territory relations between Delhi and the central government and the national capital territory of Delhi. So this is an editorial discussing that. So the case, one of the issue has been on services, on government services as such, or transfers, that has been referred to a 3-judge bench now. Then this is strange emergency. So this is regarding emergency in USA. President Donald Trump has undermined American democracy further by declaring emergencies to get his border wall built along the Mexico border. Then the lead article, the challenge in the Pulwama attack. So this article talks how India cannot achieve its strategic objectives if Kashmiris remain targets of harassment and minorities are vilified. And so we need long-term and eventual solution to the Kashmir issue. And this is how the 16th Lok Sabha fared. So this is regarding how the 16th Lok Sabha, which important bills were passed, and how the debate went on, and it says that looking forward there must be debate on anti-defection law. So anti-defection law is one major aspect with respect to parliamentary functioning, so that is spoken of. Then there is nothing important on the op-ed page. On page 10 you have Kashmiris face threats, nearly 100 return home. So after the CRPF Pulwama attack, we have seen around 100 Jammu and Kashmir students from various colleges across North India, mostly from Dehradun and Uttarakhand, have returned to the Kashmir Valley. So this is because they are facing threats in the place where they are learning because of their Kashmiri origin. So this is what is coming forth now. So a terrorist attack which is linked to Pakistan, and if Kashmiri students are such are targeted because of that, then it says a lot about how the country is going to move ahead. Then on international page you have US asks Europe to take back IS fighters. So this is Syrian Democratic Forces which hold hundreds of foreigners accused of fighting for jihadist group IS. On business page you have states allocation. Panel sticks to 2011 census. So this is the 15th Finance Commission. It is said it will not alter its approach on solely using the 2011 census for population figures, so for allocation to states. So Chairman of 15th Finance Commission N.K. Singh has said so in an interview. So these proposals will impact central budget and those presented by states for 2020-21. Then this is Directorate General of Civil Aviation keeping tabs on IndiGo's crew strength. So, airline needs to match its fleet expansion. So, the Director General of Civil Aviation is looking into the matter. Then on Mondays, you have business review coverage. So, here this is the coverage on mutual fund industry. So, how it has been growing in the country. So, though assets under management have increased drastically over the years, but still you can see that inflows have dropped in the past few months. This also shows about the states. The state with biggest investors is Maharashtra, and this is regarding where the mutual funds invest. So 40% of it is in equity oriented schemes, around 42%. Then comes debt oriented schemes, even part of it is liquid also. So the assets which they have under management, how they invest it is shown. Then this is inflation is tamed, but households don't think so. So though we see the economic indicators showing that inflation is quite low, but then it is not felt. So how the reason for the gap between perception and reality is crucial to indicate inflation is well under control. So though the government says inflation is low, the government data says so, it has to be felt as such too. So that is spoken of in this. And this is incubating agroforestry models, an idea blooms. So this is regarding agroforestry, which is considered as an emerging industry. So that is spoken of here. And this is NBFCs will retain place under the sun. So non-banking finance companies will stay, but then there will be a reset in liquidity strategies, which is expected from them at even non-retail asset quality. That has to improve. Then on the last page you have scientists discover massive mountains under Earth's crust. So this is a discovery which shows the topography on the layer located 660 km below the Earth's surface. So here the scientists have discovered massive mountains in the Earth's mantle. Then below you have what the world needs is a personal war on plastic. So there is nearly 300 million tons of plastic created worldwide each year, including single-use items like straw, which end up in landfills or oceans. So it's a personal war on plastic which is required to end the menace. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. In the current affairs section, you can even download monthly compilations here. Also, you can download daily PDFs here, which are uploaded. So these are made available here. So that is it. You can also see the month coverage on the entire uploads up here. So that is it. Thank you.